Yesterday we were discussing example on the work done in carrying a charge from point B to point A. Is it not? I hope screen is seen, students. Screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Note down this example, students. Second example. Determine work done in carrying a charge of -2 coulomb from 2, 1, -1 to 8, 2, -1 in the electric field E bar is equal to Y AX bar plus X AY bar volt per meter in Cartesian coordinates, considering the path along the parabola X is equal to 2Y square. Take the question, problem statement. Is it noted, students? Note down only the statement of the problem. We'll solve it. Is it noted?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Make it fast.
Yes, sir, complete.
Okay. Read the problem statement. Determine work done in carrying a charge of -2 coulomb. They are asking to find the work done in carrying a charge of -2 coulomb from the point 2, 1, -1 to 8, 2, -1. That is, point B is 2, 1, -1 and point A is 2, 8, 2, -1. In the electric field, they are given the electric field, that is Y AX bar plus X AY bar volt per meter, and they have clearly mentioned to use the Cartesian coordinates. Sometimes they will mention in the question, sometimes they will not, they may not mention in the question. And if they are mentioning in the question, you have to consider that coordinate itself and you have to solve it. Sometimes they will not mention, you have to identify which coordinate system they are asking and then you have to solve accordingly. Considering the path along the parabola X is equal to 2y square. That means the point from where they are moving, this point B to point A, it is on the parabola X is equal to 2y square. If it is so, then we have to find the work done in moving a charge of -2 coulomb. Okay. We know the formula here. The formula is W is equal to minus Q integral E bar dot dl bar over the limits B to A, over the integral B to A. Starting point is B and the final point is A. That we have seen in the previous class. Correct? The formula that we took up in the previous class, this formula, W is equal to minus Q integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. Write down the formula first. Then substitute the given values. Q is given, it is -2 coulomb. Minus of Q is -2. Integral E bar is Y AX bar plus X AY bar dot dl bar. What is dl bar in Cartesian? Dl bar in Cartesian, can you tell me, students? Dl bar in Cartesian coordinate, it is equal to, is given by what? DL. It is given by, in Cartesian coordinates, what is the differential length DL given by? Yes, please. Differential and DL. Can you recollect what we discussed yesterday? Yes, please. What is the differential length dl given by in Cartesian system? It is dl bar is equal to x dx plus y dy plus z dz. Is it not? Differential length dl is given by dx ax bar dy ay bar plus dz az bar. Sorry, dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz az bar. This is the formula for the differential length dl bar. Okay, substitute that dot dl bar. It is dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz az bar. Okay, then we have to take the dot product. Okay, solve this one. Next step, after this step, get the third step, solve it. Everyone should solve it. It is integral y ax bar plus x ay bar dot of dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz az bar. Do the next step. What you are getting the next step? Yes, please. Third step, how much you are getting answer? Harsh Gowda? Harsh Gowda? How much you are getting third step? 2 into?
Sir, doing, sir.
Doing, okay. Do it. Ankita? Ankita?
Yes, sir.
How much you're getting? Third step? What is the equation?
Sorry, sir.
Third step.
Solving.
Solving. Okay. Solve. Janvi. Janvi. What is the third step you are getting? Mahadev? Mahadev Wadeyar?
Sir, madam, entry.
Madam.
Sir?
Yes, please. Come on, tell me. I'm not asking the final answer. Tell me the third step. After I explain the second step, what will be the third step equation?
Sir, 2 into integral y of 4y dy.
Plus?
Plus integral 2y square dy.
Exactly. Very good. How you got that? Yes, please. Look here. What is given here? X is equal to 2y square. X is equal to 2y square. Is it not? This is the equation of the parabola. X is 2y square. Differentiate this. Dx will be equal to 2 into differentiation of y square. That is 2y dy. So it is 2 into 2y is 4y dy. Therefore, we will get dx is equal to 4y dy. That is 2 into integral y dx. This equation y ax bar dot dx ax bar. First, we have to solve this first. Y ax bar dot dx ax bar. Ax bar dot ax bar is 1. Y into dx is y dx. Plus. Okay. Then ay bar dot ay bar. You have to dot ay bar with the ay bar only. Corresponding, you have to dot. Okay. Ay bar dot ay bar is 1. X into dy. That is integral x dy. There is no z component, so there is no question of the dz there. Therefore, we will get 2 into integral y dx plus integral x dy. But now here we are having x is equal to 2y square. If I differentiate that, I will get dx is equal to 4y dy. That will be 2 into integral y dx is how much? 4y dy. Write it. Substitute that. Plus integral x is 2y square. Substitute dy. If I simplify this, I will get 2 into, this is 4, integral y into y is y square dy plus 2 into integral y square dy. Okay. Note down up till this step and tell me the answer of the numerical. Note down up this up till this step, students, first. And tell me the final answer. Have you solved it, students? What you are getting?
Sir, 28, sir.
28 unit. Unit of work?
Joule.
Joules, correct.
Yeah.
Others getting the same answer? Or any different answers? What about others? Kirti? Kirti, Rohan, okay, Rohan,
yes sir,
how much you are getting, final answer, have you solved it,
solving sir,
okay, do it please,
sir, 28 joules,
28, correct, you are right, Ruthik Chopra, Ruthik,
yes sir,
have you solved it, Ruthik,
yes sir, it is 28 joules,
28 joules. Fine. Ruthvik?
Yes, sir.
How much you are getting, Ruthvik? Have you solved it?
Yes, sir. I solved it. It's 28 joules, sir.
Correct. You are right. Fine, students. The answer is 28 joules. Quickly, we'll see how it is 28 joules. 2 into 4 into integration y square dy plus 2 into integration y square dy. So, as the terms here are similar, right? Y square dy, this is also y square dy, and the integrals are also similar. Therefore, I can add these two. So, it will be 6 into integral y square dy. The limits of y, you have to look into these coordinates. Okay. The limits of y, x, y, z, x, y, z. We are moving from B to A. B coordinate, y coordinate of point B is 1. Y coordinate of point B is 1. And y coordinate of point A is 2. Therefore, the integrals you have to take from 1 to 2 y square dy. 6 into 2 is 12. Integral of y square is y cube divided by 3, n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. That will be over the limits 1 to 2. Then 3 ones are 3, 4s are 12. So it is 4 into y cube over the limits 1 to 2. That will be 2 raised to 3 minus 1 raised to 3. That is 4 into 2 raised to 3 is 8 minus 1. It is 7. Therefore, it will be 4 into 7, 28 joules. Okay. So answer is 28 joules. Fine. This is how we will have to solve such examples. This is an examination numerical. It has been asked in the examination. And the previous one was also from the examination question paper. Okay. Next topic, we'll move on to what is called as the potential difference. Of course, you know the meaning of potential difference. Let us see how this potential difference is applied to our subject, that is electromagnetic field theory here. Work done in moving a point charge from point B to point A. Work done in moving point charge from point B to point A in the electric field E bar is given by the equation W is equal to minus Q integral from B to A E bar dot dl bar. This is the equation. We already know this equation. We have obtained this equation yesterday. W is equal to minus Q integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. If I select this charge Q as unity, that means the magnitude of the charge Q is unity, unit test charge, then above equation will give me the work done in moving the unit charge from point B to point A in the electric field intensity E bar. What I have considered here, I have considered the magnitude of this charge Q to be 1, to be unity. Then if so, the equation here will give me work done in moving unit charge from point B to point A in the electric field intensity, that is E bar. What it indicates here, work done in moving unit charge from point B to A in the electric field E bar. Work done in moving one charge, one magnitude charge, unit charge from point B to point A in the electric field E bar is called as the potential difference between the two points B and A. Work done in moving unit charge from point B to A in the electric field intensity E bar is called the potential difference between these two points B and A. And this potential difference is denoted by the letter V. It is denoted by the letter V. That means a potential difference, I can rewrite the above equation. Instead of W, I will use V now because I have calculated the potential difference, that is the work done in moving unit charge. Therefore, instead of W, I am writing it as V. V is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. Charge Q magnitude is 1. I am moving unit charge from point B to A, and hence it is simply 1. Therefore, it will be V is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. That is the equation. If B is the starting point and A is the final point, then the potential difference is denoted by VAB. If B is starting point and A is the final point, this voltage, whatever we have calculated between B to A, is called as potential difference, and it is denoted by VAB. That is, it is the potential difference between the points B to A when one unit of charge is moved from B to A in the electric field intensity E bar. That is, instead of V, I can rewrite it as VAB is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. VAB is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot dl bar, because it is potential difference between B to A. This potential difference VAB, it is work done in moving unit test charge from infinity to the point. Okay, the work done in moving unit charge from infinity is considered as a reference point, from infinity to the point is called as potential of that point. Okay, what is electric potential? How is the electric potential defined? The definition of electric potential is the work done in moving unit charge from infinity to that point, to some point, is called as electric potential of that point. This is the definition of the electric potential. Here infinity is taken as the reference point. Okay, then what is the unit of potential difference? What is the unit of potential difference? The potential difference is work done per unit charge. We know that V is equal to W by Q. V is equal to W by Q. Okay, the work done is measured in joules, whereas the charge is measured in coulombs. And hence, the potential difference is joules divided by coulombs. That is, V is W by Q. Voltage or potential difference is equal to work done divided by charge. Work done unit is joules, charge unit is coulomb. Hence, I can write the unit of potential difference as joules divided by coulomb, or joules per coulomb. Practically, we use the unit as volts. 1 volt potential difference. Now, if I want to define 1 volt potential difference, how to define this? 1 volt potential difference is the amount of work done in moving one unit of charge from one point to the other in the electric field E bar. 1 volt potential difference is 1 joule of work done in moving unit charge from one point to another point in the electric field E bar. This is called as 1 volt potential difference, or potential difference of 1 volt. Clear here? I hope everyone are following here. Yes. Any difficulty up till here, students? Any difficulty up till here?
No, sir.
Okay. The next one, potential due to point charge. Consider a point charge placed at the point Q, that is the origin point, at the point of origin, which is the center of the spherical system. I am considering a point charge located at the origin of a spherical coordinate system, which is producing the electric field intensity E bar radially in all the directions. The point charge Q, whichever I have placed at the at the center of the spherical system or at the origin, that is radiating the electric field intensity in all the directions radially along the radius of the sphere. I am considering one point as A and the distance from the origin to this point is RA. Then one more point B I am considering, the distance of this point B from the origin is RB. Fine. The distance of point A from the origin is RA, distance of point B from the origin is RB. Okay. Let us look into the further details. What we are doing here, friends, we are finding the potential due to the point charge. How much is the voltage of the point charge which is placed at the origin or which is placed at the center of the spherical system? Let us assume free space, medium as free space. Then E bar due to point charge Q at a point R, at a point with the radius R. Let us assume free space medium. The electric field intensity, the electric field intensity at a distance of R, at a distance of small r from the origin, that is given by the equation E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR bar. This equation is electric field intensity equation. E is equal to Q, that is the point charge which is placed at the origin, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. R is the distance at which we are finding the electric field intensity. 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR bar. Okay. Let us consider a unit charge which is placed at point B. We are considering unit charge placed at point B at a distance of RB from the origin. Consider a unit charge placed at point B at a radial distance of RB from the origin. Next, what I am doing is I am moving this point charge which I have placed at point B to point A against the electric field. Yesterday we discussed that there is a repulsive force on the test charge that we are placing in the electric field due to the base charge. This charge which we have placed at the center of the spherical system or at the origin, this is called as the base charge. And the charge that we have placed in the electric field outside this, that is called as the test charge. Okay. There is a repulsive force between the two, between the base charge and the test charge. When I am moving the point charge which I have placed at the point B to the point A, then there is opposition of the repulsive force. I am moving against the repulsive force. The point A, it is moved against the direction of E bar from point B to point A. The point A is at a radial distance of RA from the origin. This point A, it is at distance RA. Then the differential length in spherical system. You will have to remember this formula, students. Differential length in a Cartesian we discussed just now. This is the equation for the differential length in spherical system. Differential length in spherical system is given by the equation dl is equal to dr ar bar plus r d theta a theta bar plus r sine theta d phi a phi bar. It is dl is equal to dr ar bar plus r d theta a theta bar plus r sin theta d phi a phi bar, because we know that the coordinates in the spherical system are r, theta and phi in Cartesian x, y, z, and in cylindrical r, phi and z. Hence the potential difference VAB between points A and B is given by, potential difference between points A and B, I can write the equation as VAB is equal to minus integral B to A minus integral B to A, because I am moving the charge of unit magnitude from point B to point A. Hence, it is VAB is equal to minus integral from B to A, E bar dot dl bar, E bar dot dl bar. That is the our equation what we got in the previous one. VAB is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot dl bar. Write that equation. Then find out the limits. What is distance B? What is the distance A? B distance is the distance that is at RB. This B distance is at a distance of RB. A point is at a distance of RA. Yes or no? B is at a distance of RB and A is at a distance of RA. Substitute these limits. B is at RB and A is at RA. Therefore, VAB will be minus integral RB to RA. It is from point B to point A. The distance is RB to RA. Q divided by E is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR bar. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught square AR bar. The previous equation, equation 1. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR bar. Substitute that dot of dl bar. Dl bar is second equation. Vr ar bar plus r d theta a theta bar plus r sin theta d phi a phi bar. If we dot this with this, then what will be the equation? Ar bar dot ar bar. It is 1. Ar bar dot a theta bar is how much, friends? What is ar bar dot a theta bar? Can anybody tell me? Ar bar dot a.
Zero, sir.
It is 0. Because there is no question of theta component here, is it not? Because theta is not there, only there is r component, therefore we are dotting ar bar with dr bar, that is 1. Then we have dr. There is no question of d, theta component or the phi component. Fine. Then vab is minus integral rb to ra q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square a bar dot ar bar is 1. It is simply dr. That is vab is equal to minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught integral rb to ra. If I take this 1 by r square to the numerator, if I take r square which is at denominator to numerator, it will be r is to minus 2, r is to minus 2 dr. So it will be minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught r raised to minus 2 integration is how much? If you integrate r raised to minus 2, what you will get? X raised to minus n. This is of the form x raised to n minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. That is r raised to minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 over the limits RB to RA. Simplify further. Minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. This will be minus 1 by R. R is to minus 1 I will take to the denominator. It will be R is to plus 1 minus 1 by R over the limits RB to RA. That is minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into the bracket. Minus 1 by R, I am substituting the limits, minus 1 by RA, minus of minus 1 by RB. Hence, I will get VAB is equal to minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, minus 1 by RA, minus into minus is plus, plus 1 by RB. That is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 upon RA minus 1 by RB. If I multiply this minus side and inside, I will get Q by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 1 upon RA minus 1 by RB. Volts. This is the equation for the potential difference between two points A and B for the given point charge. In this equation, if RB is greater than RA, okay, then what will happen? If RB is greater than RA, 1 by RB will be less than 1 by RA. Am I right? Suppose the value of RB is large as compared to RA, right? What will happen? 1 by RB. Suppose if you are taking RA 1 by 2 and RB as 1 by 5. What will be the answer? 1 by 2 is 0.5. 1 by 5 is 0.2. So 1 by RB will be less than 1 by RA, correct? Then the value of VAB will be positive. If RB is greater than RA, 1 by RB is less than 1 by RA, and hence VAB will be positive. So this is the amount of work done by or for moving the charge from point B, from the point B to the point A. In moving unit charge from point B to point A, this is the amount of work done. You all understood this derivation, friends? Potential due to point charge. Any difficulty here in this derivation? Is this derivation clear?
Understood, sir.
Okay, right. Let's move on to the next concept. Concept of absolute potential. Instead of finding the values of the potentials, just now whatever equation we got, instead of that, we can use one more concept called as concept of absolute potential. Absolute potential is we are measuring the potential or the voltage with reference to certain point. We are taking some point as the reference and measuring the voltage at our point with respect to the reference point. This is called as concept of absolute potential. For example, if we take the coaxial cable or the shielded cable, the outer layer or the outer portion of the cable, okay, outer layer of the cable is connected to ground. This is because to avoid the electromagnetic interferences that are caused by the nearing cables. If there is any electromagnetic interference from the nearing cable, the ground portion, whatever is connected to the outer portion of the cable, that will make the noise signals to be grounded. Okay, that is the reason the ground is connected to the outer portion of the coaxial cable or the shielded cable. Right? Then the optical fibers that we are using, they are all the coaxial cables. Nowadays, the optical fiber communication, what all we are using, okay, for our cell phone communication, okay, all those internet applications, that is all coaxial cable, right? So here, what is done is the noise is avoided, and the whatever potentials we are measuring inside the coaxial cable, that is with respect to the reference potential. Practically speaking, the ground potential is taken as the reference potential for practical purposes. And ground potential is always considered as zero potential. Okay. So that is the points I have highlighted here. Instead of potential difference, it is more convenient to express absolute potentials of various points in the field. Such absolute potentials are measured with respect to always some reference point. Such reference position or reference point is called as the, or it is assumed as the zero potential. Now for practical purposes, zero reference point is selected as the ground point or the ground as the reference. Consider potential difference VAB due to movement of unit charge from B to A in the field of the electric field intensity. In the field of electric field intensity, or where point charge Q is located at origin, let us consider potential difference VAB. Then the equation VAB is given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. Correct? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, that is the previous equation what we derived here. VAB is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. Potential difference due to point charge. Correct? From that equation, let the charge be moved from infinity to point A. Now what I am doing, I am considering the infinite position as my reference. Infinite position as my reference. I am moving the unit charge from the infinity to the point A. Point B is at infinity. This point B is at infinity now, point B. I am moving unit charge from this infinity, that is at point B, to the point A. If I am doing so, then the distance RB will be infinity. This distance RB will be infinity. This distance RB, because B is at infinity, hence the distance RB will be equal to infinity. Thus, we get 1 by RB is equal to 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity means how much? What is 1 by infinity? 1 by infinity is how much? We are dividing infinity. We are dividing 1 by infinity is 0. Okay, it is 0. Therefore, VAB will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 upon RA. 1 by RB is 1 by infinity, so it is 0. Hence, I will get this will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA volts. This equation represents potential of the point A denoted as VA. VAB is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA volts indicates the potential of the point A at the point A. That is, VA is equal to the previous equation. I am replacing VAB by V because I got the potential at point A. Therefore, it will be VA is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA volts. VA is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA volts. This is called absolute potential of point A. The reference to the infinity, which I have considered as the reference, my absolute potential at the point A is given by this equation. is given by this equation. Similarly, if I want the absolute potential of the point B, okay, I'm considering one more charge at infinity and I'm finding the absolute potential at point B. And that will be just replace Ra by Rb. It will be Vb is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb volts. That means the potential difference. Now tell me, students, what will be the potential difference between B to A or A to B? Difference, potential difference, difference in the potential between points A and B will be how much? What is the equation? What is meant by potential difference? The difference in the potential between two points. Correct? The difference in the potential between two points. If you are considering one point as A, another point as B, whatever is the difference between these two points in potentials? Whatever is the difference in potential between these two points, right? That is called as our potential difference. We got VA as the potential of absolute potential of A, VB as the absolute potential of point B. Therefore, VA minus VB, that will give us the potential difference VAB. Correct? The potential difference can be expressed as the difference between the absolute potentials of the two points. That is, the equation will be VAB will be equal to VA minus VB volts. Hence, absolute potential at any point which is at distance r from the origin, we are finding the absolute potential at a distance r from the origin, and at the origin a point charge q is located. It is at the origin the point charge q is located. We are finding the absolute potential at some distance r from this origin in the spherical system. Then the equation for that absolute potential is given by V is equal to 4q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r. The same equation, whatever you have got earlier, VA or VB, that is q by 4 pi epsilon naught ra. Instead of ra, I will replace it by small r, which is the distance r from the center of the sphere. That is, V is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Instead of ra here, I will just replace that by r. Here the reference point is at infinity. That's what I am told here. I told here that whatever the charge we are considering at whatever point we are considering at infinity, and the charge, unit charge we are moving from infinity, the infinite position is considered as the reference point. Potential due to point charge not at origin. I will quickly complete this within 2 minutes. It's a small topic. If the point charge q is not located at the origin of a spherical system, suppose say if the point charge q is not located at the origin, it is located somewhere else. Till now what we have assumed? We have assumed that the point charge q is located at the origin of the spherical system. Suppose if the point charge q is not located at the origin, it is located some other point. Look at this figure. Here the point charge q is located at some point which is at distance r dash from the origin, and we are interested in finding the potential at the point A. We are interested in finding the potential at the point A, which is at a distance r from the origin. Then what we are supposed to do here? The test charge, the unit charge is q, which is located at distance r dash. It is not located at origin. It is located at distance r dash from origin, and we are finding how much is the potential at the point A, which is at distance r, small r from the origin. Then if I want to do so, then this distance vector is given by the destination minus source. Destination is A, that is a distance r, minus source, that is minus r dash, minus r dash. Once I find this ra, then substitute in the equation, that is absolute potential at point A located at distance r from the origin is given by the equation Vr is equal to Va. Va, that is the voltage at point A, potential at point A, is q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r minus r dash, where ra is equal to r minus r dash. This is ra here. What was the previous equation we have got? This is for r, q by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Instead of r, now I am having r minus r dash, because that is a distance vector. This formula we obtained in the previous one, that is when considering the unit charge to be at origin. Now the unit charge is not at the origin, it is at some other coordinate, some other distance, some other point, and hence V will be equal to q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r minus, that is r minus r dash. where Ra is R minus R dash. What is this R minus R dash? R minus R dash is the distance between the point at which we are finding the potential and the point at which the unit charge is located. Ra is, this Ra is the distance between, or the distance vector between the point at which we are finding the potential and the point charge at which, and then the point at which the unit charge is located, and the point at which the unit charge is located. That is our distance Ra, correct? That is Ra is equal to R minus R dash. That is the distance between point at which potential is to be calculated and the location of the charge. Hence, the equation will be Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R dash. That is this distance R minus this distance R minus R dash, correct? Distance vector, how we will calculate? It is from this to this point minus this to this point, R minus R dash. That is, final equation is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Ra, where Ra is R minus R dash, which is nothing but, again, distance between point at which potential is to be calculated and the location of the charge. Okay. In today's class, students, I hope this topic is understood, students. Potential due to point charge not at origin. Is it clear, this topic? Potential due to point charge not at origin?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine.
Yes, sir.
Fine, fine, fine.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In today's class, friends, I'll give a recap of what we discussed in today's class. We have solved an example on work done in carrying a charge, and then topic on potential difference, starting from the basic equation of the work done. We have derived the equation VAB is equal to minus integral B to A E bar dot DL bar. Then unit of potential difference, it is joules per coulomb, or it is practically volt. Potential due to point charge, that is charge located at a point at the origin. Then if we want to find the potential at some other point away from the origin, and that is given by the equation V is equal to, or VAB is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 upon Ra minus 1 by Rb volts. Then later we understood what is absolute potential, that is, it is the potential that we are finding with respect to certain reference point. Okay, that is our absolute potential. Absolute potential. Fine. Then for the absolute potential, we derived the equations for the absolute potential. Va, it is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Ra volts. Vb is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb volts. Then later we found the potential difference between these two absolute potentials. That is, Vab is equal to Va minus Vb. That is, this equation minus this equation, that gives Va minus Vb, or the potential difference between the two absolute potentials. If we consider a point at a distance r from the origin, then its potential is given by V is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Potential due to point charge not at the origin, if some point we are considering where we are placing the unit charge, and it is not at the origin, and we are finding the potential at some other point. Here we are finding at point A the potential. Then the equation will be Vr is equal to, or Va is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R dash, or that is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Ra, where Ra is equal to R minus R dash. It is the distance between the point at which potential is to be calculated and the location of the unit charge. I hope everyone understood here. Any difficulty here, students?
Any difficulty? No, sir. Here? Yes, sir. No problem. No difficulties.
Okay. Fine. Fine, students. Harsh Gowda, any difficulty? Harsh Gowda?
No, sir. Understood, sir.
Okay. Fine. Karthik? Karthik Patil? Karthik? Okay. What about other students? Abhishek?
No.
Okay, fine. No, Abhishek? Sir. Understood, no, Abhishek? No, any difficulty here?
No,
okay.
No, sir. No,
okay.
Difficulty.
Fine. Deepa Lamani? Deepa?
Yes, sir.
Was it clear, Deepa, today's discussion?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Atiya? Atiya Devlapur? Atiya? Was it understood, Atiya? Any difficulty, any questions? Atiya? Any questions? Any doubts you are having? Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay. Lohit, Lohit Dudmani. Any questions?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts, Lohit? No. Okay,
no, sir,
fine.
No, sir.
Okay. Prajwal Mali, Prajwal. Any doubts you are having, Prajwal? Any questions? Any problem in understanding? Okay. Rohan Timsani, Rohan.
Yes, sir.
Any problem in understanding, Rohan? Understood today's discussion concepts. Okay. Ritik Chopra, Ritik. Was it understood, Ritik? Today's discussion.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Fine, fine. Okay. Samir Khaji, Samir. Khaji.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Understood. Okay. Shraddha, Shraddha.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear today's discussion, Shraddha?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay. Shweta Paushe? Shweta?
Yes, sir.
Any problem in understanding, Shweta, on today's topic? Okay,
no, sir.
Fine. Okay, students. Okay, students, in the next class, we'll continue with the in the topic on potential. Still, some more subtopics are there on potential. We'll take up those topics in the next class. Thank you.